I will show you the last small hands-on, which you don't need to repeat as me. I only wanted to show you this feature. Inside the cube hull package, we always have a lot of the examples which are dedicated to our boards. They are dedicated to the Discovery, to Nucleus, whatever board we have. But disadvantage was that you must always copy the complete hull package. And then if you want only one example, you need to delete the rest, which was a little bit annoying and take a lot of the time only if you want to test one feature. Then for this, it's now possible to start the example directly from the IDE or the MX. And you will choose the example. And then the CubeMX or the CubeMDE will copy this specific example into the place which you will select. Then you don't need to do it anymore manually and delete a lot of the stuff. It will be done automatically, which can easier help you to start with some prototyping or test the features which you don't know. This is also a recommended way how to start to learn with the periphery which you never used before. And how to do it in the Cube IDE is the simple way. And as before, it's usually starting with the import. Then I will try to repeat it. And I will open my IDE like before. And again, we starting with the import. And inside here, we selecting the import STM32 cube example. And if we go there, then he will open for us the explorer of all the examples which exist for all the devices. And we can filter them like we filter the STM devices. And I know that I have F735 Discovery kit. Then I can select all examples written directly for this Discovery kit. And I can see the example type, if it's the example, if it's the application, which is usually using together with some IPs, also some library like graphic, like crypto, like USB. And if this example is using the low level or the hull driver, I think if you right click here on the column, you can select more filters which will be visible. I have here only the ones which are important for me, which means the driver, the type, and the device. Then you can select the example. I think the one example which I liked was the display with two layers, because there was at least something visible on the screen. And he will asking me where will be the location, and I'm okay to put it inside the ecosystem workshop. And it's a standard example, completely the same as is inside the hull package. Like now, only part which is missing is currently on the H7 are not examples with the IOC files. They are currently coming for the all new devices and for the last devices. I believe I think the WL currently have them, and I think maybe L5 already have them. And I believe that in the time it will came also for the H7. Because it's a very useful family. And good thing to mention that inside the example is usually README for this example. And the README contains a lot of the important information. Definitely there is the description how the example is working. And also sometimes very important description how to make the example work, because sometimes it's necessary to change something on the board with the jumpers, with the solder bridges, or you need to run some specific software together with the examples, like some terminal, like some web server or the standard TCP server or so on, then it's good to check the README before you start playing with these examples. Then this was the very short introduction about this part, which I wanted to show. Last part, if you want the original demo, which was on the discovery kit, because we unfortunately read complete memory and the OctoSPI, prepared the one bat file. I think it was the program original hex file, which is possible to use to program the original demo back. Restore it with this binary called program original hex file. And I hope that it will work. If not, there is the second possibility. Download this from the web page. You can use the Cube Programmer tool. And it's possible to download directly the demo there, this hex file, by selecting, connecting first with the programmer, selecting the external loader, which is the same like in the IDE. I need to select the loader for F735 somewhere, 735. And here inside the async and programming, I must select the binary, which is inside the tools, is the 75 megabyte binary. And I can click on the program and he will program everything. But be careful, because of the size of the binary, which is probably 60 megabytes, which needs to be programmed into the OctoSPI, the operation takes minutes, maybe 5 or 10 minutes, then do it only when you have time. And it will restore the original demo. Okay, that this was all from my side.